Before watching the video, do subscribe my channel and hit the bell notification icon to get the instant update. Carboxylic acids, the first part is about the classification of the carboxylic acid. And this classification is first based on the number of COOH groups. So if you have one COOH group, the compound would be called as a monocarboxylic acid. With two COOH, they are referred as dicarboxylic acid. And with three, they are referred as tricarboxylic acid. Now in monocarboxylic acid with a single COOH, the nomenclature is already studied. And we have the prefixes which are already defined as form, acid, propion, butyr, valer, capro and benzo. Now add the suffix IC acid, you get the common names of all the carboxylic acids. Okay, mainly with 6 carbon atoms and the aromatic benzoic acid. Correct. Now how these names are actually derived, the concept is here. These names, yani the prefixes form, acid, propion, are actually derived from the source where the carboxylic acid is found. It's related with the source of carboxylic acid. For example, if I talk about the first one, like form. Form is related with formica. And formica in Latin means red ants. So when the red ants bite, they inject formic acid into the body. Hence the source of formic acid is formica, meaning red ants. And that's how the name formic acid was assigned to it. Okay? So the form is related to formica. Next, acid is related with acetum. Acetum refers to vinegar, and vinegar contains about 6 to 8% of acetic acid. Vinegar contains 6 to 8% of acetic acid, and from there the acetic name is derived. The third one is propion. Now propion is actually a Greek word which is related with pro, yani first, and pion means fat. So propion or propionic acid was considered to be the first fat, and that is why the name propionic acid was given to 3-carbon carboxylic acid. Okay, first fat. Uske baad we have butyr. Now the word butyr is related to butyrum, and butyrum refers to butter. So because of the buttery odor or the presence of butyraldehyde in butter, it's related with the word butyrum. Okay, so related with butter. Next is valer. Valer is related with the root of valerian plant. The root of valerian plant contains the valeric acid, and hence the name valeric acid is assigned to it. Okay? And the last one, capro. Now the word capro is related to goat's milk. Goat's milk contain caproic acid, and hence the word capro refers to goat's milk. Okay? So again, the reference was related with formica or red ants, acetum or vinegar, propion means first fat, butyr refers to butyrum or butter. Valer is related with root of valerian plant. Capro is related with goat's milk. Okay? So this is how the monocarboxylic acids were actually named. Okay? And benzo was obviously related with the benzene structure, and the name benzoic acid was given to aromatic acids. Okay? Now let's understand few of the examples of monocarboxylic acids with nomenclature. If I have the structure as CH3C CH3CH3CH2COOH, firstly common name. It's neocaproic acid. Whenever I talk about the common name, first thing is to identify the total number of carbon atoms. And when I say total, matlab including the branches and the carbon of COH. So the first thing in common name is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon, and 6 matlab reference to capro. Hence the prefix assigned to this will be capro. With IC acid, it's caproic acid. And with respect to the alkyl group, if you see, this is the neopentyl. Hence from the neopentyl, the word neo would be assigned. Hence neocaproic acid. Clear with that? IUPAC, the longest chain would be selected from? From the COOH. By default, the COOH will always have the position 1, meaning they are the terminal compounds. And hence we have the IUPAC name as 3,3-dimethyl butanoic acid. एंड वन ऑइक एसिड लिखो या नहीं लिखो डिफॉल्ट हो जाता है बिकॉज ऑफ द टर्मिनल पोजिशन. ठीक है. थर्डली वी ऑल्सो हैव द ग्रीक नेमिंग सिस्टम विथ रेफरेंस टू अल्फा बीटा. So in this case, the alpha carbon is CH2. So with reference to that, this will be beta and gamma. Hence the name. Beta, comma, beta, dimethyl, not butanoic acid, butyric acid. It will be related with the common name system. So 3,3 dimethyl. Now instead of the butanoic in IUPAC, in the Greek, we have to name it as butyric acid. Clear? And rest of the nomenclature is exactly similar to aldehyde, because aldehydes mein everything was same. Instead of the COH there was CHO, and instead of the oic acid we were using the word al. Clear? Baki sab cheez exactly same hi tha, koi farak nahi hai nomenclature mein. Theek hai? So aldehydes and acids have the similar nomenclature with the similar type of naming system. Theek hai? Ab coming to the dicarboxylic acid. Dicarboxylic acids are those which have two COH, and the simplest of that which you can think about is oxalic acid, because it's COH bonded with COH. Now we have the sequence of the dicarboxylic acids which needs to be remembered. Matlab yahan par we just go on increasing the carbon atom by introducing a methylene group in between. So now this three carbon dicarboxylic acid is called malonic acid. It's named as malonic acid. If I increase it one more, it's called succinic acid. It's called succinic acid. If I increase one more, it is called glutaric acid. And if I increase one more, it will be adipic acid. So, 5 dicarboxylic acids you have to name, and they are to be remembered in the sequence. The first starts with minimum how many carbon?
Two.
The oxalic acid is a dicarboxylic acid with 2 carbon atoms. So it's oxalic, malonic, succinic, glutaric and adipic. And the structures are simple. You have to just go on adding a methylene group in between. So the sequence can be remembered as OMS-GA, OMS and GA. That is oxalic, malonic, succinic, glutaric and adipic. Clear? Or IUPAC of this would be simple. If I talk about the IUPAC of this, when I have one COH, it's oic acid. So for two, it will be dioic acid. And for two carbons, it will be
ethane
dioic acid with the position 1 and 2. Now they are again the terminal position. So if you don't write the position, it's okay. Ethane dioic acid would mean the COH are at the extreme positions only. And last one with the 6 carbon atom, they will be called hexane 1,6 dioic acid. Clear with the nomenclature? Theek hai. Ab tricarboxylic acid mein we have a very important example, that is citric acid, which is found in citrus fruits, rich in vitamin C. So it's a tricarboxylic acid with the 3 COH on the adjacent carbon atoms, and on the central carbon you also have a hydroxy group. It's actually a hydroxy tricarboxylic acid. If I satisfy the valency, it will be H satisfied and H. Clear? This is a formula for citric acid. Ab, is case mein if you want to name the IUPAC, then longest chain will be of
5.
Two of the COH at the extremes can come as the longest chain. So in this case, the numbering can be done from any side at symmetry. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now this 2 will become the substituent. OH as a substituent is called hydroxy, and COH carboxyl. So it will be 3 carboxyl, 3 hydroxyl pentane, 1,5 dioic acid would be the IUPAC name. Clear? Now just one more example of a polyfunctional compound. If I have CH3C double bond O, CH with a benzene, CH2C double bond O and CHO. Then in this polyfunctional compound, the numbering will be done from CHO, because two functional groups you can observe. One is aldehyde and a ketone. And out of aldehyde ketone, aldehyde has a higher priority. So the numbering will be done from right as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now this will be considered to be a substituent named as 4-phenyl. And these two also are the substituents called oxo. So it will be 2,5-dioxo. And then the parent of 6 would be named as hexanal. So finally, in the alphabetical order, kya aayega pehle? Oxo. So it will be 2,5-dioxo-4-phenyl. Substituents ho gaya. The parent of 6 would be hex. With a single bond, it will be hexane. And for the aldehyde, it will be al. Now instead of this, if I replace the COH, obviously the priority would be of COH. And the al would have been changed to oic acid. Rest of the nomenclature would not change. It would be exactly be similar. Ek bar wapas bata deta hu. Alcohol, ether, functional isomers have a formula CnH2n+2O. Can be remembered as alkane O. Then aldehyde with a ketone is remembered as alkene O. So the formula would be CnH2NO. And then acid with esters are represented as alkene O2. ये oxygen वाले तीन molecular formulas हैं, which are always to be remembered and distinguished. Benzene having two COH on the आजू-बाजू position, it is called phthalic acid. It's called phthalic acid. And if I have benzene with two COH आमने-सामने, it's terephthalic acid. Terephthalic acid. So phthalic acid is already given. If you don't know, then write terephthalic acid is benzene with COH on the opposite position. Para wale ko terephthalic bolte hain, ortho walo ko sif phthalic acid bolte hain. Sixth one is similar to 4-carbon dicarboxylic acid, but the difference over here is it has a hydroxy group at the second carbon. So this would be the structure. And this derivative of succinic acid is actually called malic acid. It's a derivative of succinic acid, right? Because succinic is with 4-carbon and hydroxy succinic acid is called malic acid. Now there are three confusing words. One is malic acid, other is malonic acid. Now malonic is already differentiated. Malonic is 3-carbon dicarboxylic acid. Just skip this. This will be malonic acid. And there was one more, malic acid, but the spelling was like this. The unsaturated dicarboxylic acid, which is C double bond C with COOH and COOH, H, H. And this was an unsaturated dicarboxylic acid, which was cis form. And the cis form was called malic acid. Its trans form was called fumaric acid. And the differentiation could be done with the help of loss of water. So because of the COH on the same side, the loss of water is possible. It can form an anhydride, but the fumaric couldn't form the anhydride. We have the discussion about the structure of carboxylic acid. Now what is important in this is to be understood. If I have carboxylic acid, what is the hybridization of the carbon?
Sp2.
So the structure would be planar.
Yes.
And it will be written as R, C double bond O and OH. Very similar to what we have written for aldehydes and ketones. But if I talk about this carboxylic acid with reference to OH, what can you observe?
Resonance.
Because of A double bond B alternate C with a lone pair. So carboxylic acids may, because of the resonance, the structure would become stable. That is why it will be very less reactive as compared with aldehydes and ketones. So the reactions which we had observed in aldehyde ketones would not be shown by carboxylic acids because of this resonance stabilization. So there is a very important statement which needs to be remembered, that carboxylic acids do not undergo the characteristic reactions of aldehydes and ketones because of resonance stabilization of the carboxylate ion or simply the carboxylic acid also. Okay, they do not undergo the characteristic reaction. Now, what were the characteristic reactions of aldehyde ketones?
None.
Addition mein, when we talk about the reactions, they are following the NaN mechanism. But in this case, the NaN would not be possible, again because of the resonance stabilization. This will get indulged in the resonance, na? So what will happen over here is, it will give RC. This will change to double bond OH with the plus and a lone pair. And this double will change to single with oxygen having the negative charge. So it will form the resonance stabilization carboxylate ion. So the attack would not be favorable because of the stability. If we talk about carboxylic acid, it will be, this is how we write, RC double bond OO minus. Aise bhi likh sakte na? So the other structure would be RC double bond O, single bond O minus. So equivalently, the structure would be written as RC O, sigma remains at the same position, but the pi will be distributed into half, then the negative charge also half. So this is 1.5. Few of the preparations are already being understood and studied. There will be repetition. The first preparation of carboxylic acid is by oxidation. And when I say oxidation, meaning oxidation of alcohols. And in alcohols, the favorable alcohol would be a primary alcohol because it can give you the carboxylic acid with same number of carbon atom. So we have a primary alcohol written as RCH2OH. Now if the oxidation is carried out with PCC, it will form only aldehyde without affecting the double bond between the carbon atoms. But if we start with a primary alcohol and oxidize with acidified K2Cr2O7, which is a strong oxidizing agent, it will change into carboxylic acid with same number of carbon atoms. Clear? Now from aldehyde, I can convert to carboxylic acid again by further oxidizing with either PCC or PDC or K2Cr2O7 acidified, or KMnO4 is also applicable. Dilute HNO3 is also an oxidizing agent. And tolins, phthalates and schiffs, they were very important. Aldehydes are converted to carboxylic acid even by tolins, phthalates and schiffs because they are weak oxidizing agents. And the test was related with conversion of the aldehyde into acids. So remember that apart from acidified K2Cr2O7 or KMnO4, we can also use tolins, phthalates and schiffs because all convert the aldehyde into carboxylic acid, and that was also used as a distinguishing test. Okay? The second preparation is by oxidation of alkyl benzene. An interesting conversion. What are alkyl benzenes? Benzene with a alkyl group. The simplest of that is toluene. First alkyl benzene would be methyl benzene. That is nothing but toluene. Okay? Now this alkyl benzene's alkyl group could be oxidized into carboxylic acid. Previously, we had already converted toluene into benzaldehyde. Can you name the reaction? Attard's oxidation using chromyl chloride, where CrO2Cl2 was nothing but a good oxidizing agent. But it was stopping at aldehyde, matlab chromyl chloride was a weak oxidizing agent. So I can further oxidize this by using KMnO4 or K2Cr2O7. So what we have used in this reaction is a simple concept of using the alkaline KMnO4, which oxidizes the alkyl group into the carboxylic acid. The oxidation ke liye, we will require a strong oxidizing agent. So we have the toluene with alkaline KMnO4. Now it will oxidize first into the benzoate salt, that is potassium benzoate. Because we are using KMnO4, na? So first it will form a salt which is potassium benzoate. Then the salts could be converted into carboxylic acid by hydration. Not hydration. Acidification. Koi bhi salt ko acid mein convert karne ke liye acidify kar do. जैसे हमने फिनोक्साइड से फिनॉल बनाया था डाउज और रेशिक्स में, क्या करते हैं हम डाइल्यूट HCl ऐड कर देते हैं, K विल टेक अवे Cl एंड K की जगह आ जाएगा H टू फॉर्म बेंजोइक एसिड। अब खास बात इस रिएक्शन का, इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ नंबर ऑफ कार्बन ऑन द बेंजीन रिंग, द ऑक्सीडेशन बाय KMnO4 वुड ऑलवेज गिव यू द बेंजोइक एसिड। मतलब इन प्लेस ऑफ मिथाइल इफ आई यूज CH3 CH2 CH2 एंड बेंजीन, मीनिंग एन प्रोपाइल बेंजीन एंड आई अप्लाई अल्कलाइन KMnO4 व्हिच वुड ऑक्सीडाइज टू द सॉल्ट फॉलोड बाय एसिडिफिकेशन मीनिंग डाइल्यूट HCl। फाइनली दिस कार्बन व्हिच इज एक्चुअली रेफर्ड एज बेंजाइलिक कार्बन, क्या बोलते हैं बेंजाइलिक कार्बन। हाउ वाज बेंजाइलिक डिफाइंड? फिनाइल प्लस CH2, बेंजीन के ऊपर जो कार्बन है उसको हम बेंजाइलिक कार्बन बोलते हैं। तो बेसिकली विद अल्कलाइन KMnO4 ओनली द बेंजाइलिक कार्बन गेट्स अफेक्टेड एंड इट विल ऑक्सीडाइज दिस इनटू द कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, द रेस्ट ऑफ द चेन इज ब्रोकन डाउन एंड दिस पार्ट विल ब्रेक डाउन एंड ऑक्सीडाइज द कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन इनटू CO2 एंड H2O। इट विल बी अ कंप्लीट ऑक्सीडेशन एंड finally combustion would give you CO2 and H2O. But here the condition is the benzylic carbon should have at least one H attached to it, meaning a benzylic hydrogen should be present. Agar benzylic hydrogen present na ho, jaise if I have a tertiary wala carbon attached with the benzene and if I apply the same reaction, there will be no reaction, no product formed, because this oxidation requires at least one H which could oxidize it to the carboxylic acid. So ye jo H aata hai yahan par, ye basically benzylic carbon ke through aata hai, and that is the reason the tertiary butyl benzene will not be able to undergo oxidation. Am I clear with this? Theek hai. Ab if I have cyclohexane with a double bond. Now we had already spoken about this, that KMnO4 and K2Cr2O7 are such strong oxidizing agent that they will be able to break the carbon to carbon double bond. So yahan par agar main alkaline KMnO4 se reaction karta hu, ye wala bond break ho jayega and the reaction product would be similar to ozonolysis. To maine ozonolysis mein kya bola tha? शॉर्टकट डबल बॉन्ड तोड़ो ऑक्सीजन जोड़ो। तो यहां पर इफ आई सी लुक एट द कार्बन, विल इट फॉर्म एन एल्डिहाइड और अ कीटोन? एल्डिहाइड। कैसे पता करना है? रिंग पे हमेशा सी लिखो, बॉन्ड्स को देखो एंड यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट देयर इज वन एच प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर। अब शॉर्टकट अप्लाई करो, डबल बॉन्ड तोड़ो, ऑक्सीजन जोड़ो, यू विल गेट CHO एंड CHO, हेक्सेन डायल बनेगा, ओपन चेन हो जाएगा विद 6 कार्बन एंड CHO एट द एक्सट्रीम पोजीशंस वुड गिव यू हेक्सेन डायल। बट KMnO4 इज अ स्ट्रांग ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट, तो एल्डिहाइड बना तो आगे कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा इनटू कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड। मतलब KMnO4 अफेक्ट्स द डबल बॉन्ड एंड कन्वर्ट्स इनटू कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड एंड 6 कार्बन डाइकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड इज कॉल्ड adipic acid. So this is a very important conversion of cyclohexane into adipic acid. I'll just give you one more variation over here. If I have cyclohexane with methyl substituted, you will get a diketone. Because in this case, mein, now if I place the carbon here, it's not having any H. Matlab this oxidation is going to give you a ketone. But ketone ka further oxidation to difficult hota hai. Possible hai. Lekin vigorous condition mein. Isliye agar ketone aaya, to ketone pe ruk jana hai. Uska further oxidation nahi sochna hai. To is case mein jo product aayega, wo kya hoga? It will be yahan se CH3 C double bond O condensed form mein CH2 repeated 4 times, then C double bond O CH3, octane dione aayega with the position 2 and 7, octane dione. So simple way mein shortcut bataya maine aapko, the oxidation of the double bond is similar to ozonolysis, but with a difference that if you get an aldehyde, change it to acid. If you get a ketone, keep as it is. In fact, ozonolysis में भी दो variation था. अगर हम zinc dust use करते हैं, तो H2O2
does not affect
the aldehyde, meaning the product would be aldehyde or ketone. But if the zinc dust is not used, it is called oxidative ozonolysis, which would give you the product similar to the action of alkaline KMnO4.
Acid.
समझा? तो यहाँ पर simple way में oxidative ozonolysis कर लो, आपका product तुरंत मिल जाएगा. Same concept of ozonolysis. Third preparation is by hydrolysis of alkyl cyanides. Now the moment I say cyanides, they are also referred as nitriles. And there were three names associated with the cyanide which I discussed in Stefan's reduction also. Stefan's reduction was conversion of cyanide to aldehyde using SnCl2 plus dilute HCl. And cyanide could also be converted to a ketone by using RMGX. वो alkyne में use किया था. Grignard's reagent and cyanide converts it into a ketone. ठीक है? अब cyanide में alkyl cyanide is the common name, but alkane nitrile would be the IUPAC name. And there was third name to the cyanide, which is prefix plus O nitrile, not alkane O nitrile. Prefix plus O nitrile. For example, if I have CH3CN, the three names are methyl cyanide, not methane nitrile. वो ही सबसे बड़ा problem है. It's ethane nitrile and acetonitrile. Cyanide word includes the carbon of the CN, hence methyl cyanide is the common name. Nitrile doesn't include the carbon, hence ethane nitrile would be the IUPAC. And the prefix related with CH3 is acid, so the third name is acetonitrile. ठीक है? अब hydrolysis of cyanides. If you remember, when aldehydes were treated with HCN, they were forming
OH
and CN. सब मिक्स कर दिए.
Cyanohydrin.
Aldehyde plus HCN, the very first addition reaction gave you cyanohydrin. And cyanohydrin के बाद मैंने बोला था cyanides के दो reactions हैं, जिसको मैंने HR reactions बोला था. Cyanide ke two reactions to be remembered as HR reaction, hydrolysis and reduction. Statement bola tha, hydrolysis of the cyanide gave you acid. This is how the preparation is. And reduction of the cyanides give you a primary amine. ठीक है? तो hydrolysis से acid कैसे बनता है? उसका detail अभी यहाँ पर. अब hydrolysis में भी दो ways हैं. One is acid hydrolysis, meaning in the presence of H plus, and other is alkaline hydrolysis in the presence of OH minus. So now, cyanides are represented as R, C, triple bond, N. Hydrolysis, we add water and in the presence of H plus. Now the water molecule in the acidic medium would break down as H plus and OH minus. And will add across the cyanide triple bond. So cyanide is already polar because of the difference in electronegativity. Carbon has a delta plus, N has a delta minus. So now plus will go and attack nitrogen. Plus minus ko attack karega, minus plus ko attack karega. ठीक है? And now from left to right, what we get is RC with OH triple gets converted to double and NH. And the moment you see C double bond N, amine. They are amines. ठीक है? Amine compounds हैं. But in this amine, there is one possible rearrangement reaction which could happen. And what was the condition of tautomerism? A double bond B, single bond C, PH. Tautomerism मतलब एक ही चीज याद रखने का, A double bond B single bond C पे H. Acidic है तो ये H को transfer to A. That's it. This is tautomerism. Nothing more to be remembered. A double bond B single bond C पे H. H will get transferred on the A या beta position. We can say that is tautomerism. So now if you observe, this is A double bond B single bond C पे H, and now this H can get transferred to N. And this amines which are unstable would get rearranged by tautomerism, and it forms R C double bond O N H 2. What compound is this? Amide. It's acid amide, not amine. It's carboxylic acid ka amide compound. So cyanides on hydrolysis in the first step gives you amide and then tautomerizes to acid amide. Now this amides could be further converted into carboxylic acid by once again hydrolysis. Now in this hydrolysis it forms H plus NOH minus. This H plus takes away the NH2 and forms ammonia and gets evolved off, and now left to right it's converted into carboxylic acid. In short, cyanide on hydrolysis gives acid, and whatever is the R, copy and paste. So it's simply CN would have COH lagao. Cyanide replaced by COOH. Clear? So if I have phenyl cyanide, the product is benzoic acid. And if I have propiononitrile, propionic acid. Now ye prefix is bahut better work karta hai, because whatever is the name of the prefix, that same corresponding acid you will get. Propiononitrile gives you propionic acid. Acetonitrile gives you acetic acid, and so on. Theek hai? Ab similar conversion we can also carry out by alkaline hydrolysis. So now the hydrolysis will be carried out in the presence of a base. Now in this case the base participates in the reaction, meaning cyanide would be broken down with water along with NaOH. Now what happens over here, the nitrogen combines with the H, H and H to form
ammonia,
and then this triple breaks to form
RCOONA
double bond, and it will form RCOONA. The bonding would be RC double bond OONA, the salt of the carboxylic acid with the liberation of ammonia. And now once I have a salt, how do I convert into carboxylic acid? Always with the acid. So dilute HCl le lo, Na plus takes away the Cl minus, and we get the carboxylic acid. That's called acidification. Any salt converted to acid, the conversion would be done by the acidification. Fourth is by preparation by addition of Grignard reagent and solid carbon dioxide, which is dry ice. Now carbon dioxide has a linear structure which can be represented as C double bond O double bond O. Now just for the reaction, I am taking it as C double bond O double bond O. Okay? And I am adding with the R MgX. Now Grignard ke bohut sare mechanism already discussed kar chuke hain, aur sab common part tha usme. In dry ether, the Grignard would first break down as R minus and MgX plus. Kuch yaad nahi rahe, ye breakdown to yaad ho jana chahiye. Then it adds across the carbonyl group similar to aldehyde ketone with plus and minus. So minus jayega plus ke pass and plus jayega minus ke pass. So now this R is bonded to carbon, will form RC double bond O unaffected. This double will change to single bond OMGX, and this particular intermediate is called Mg ka complex, which gets further hydrolyzed in presence of dilute HCl. So this MgX always takes away the OH to form MgX and OH, plus RC double bond O takes away the H to form RCOOH, which is carboxylic acid. Hence Grignard and the solid CO2 gives you carboxylic acid, with one carbon getting added from the solid carbon dioxide. So we had RMgX, now we have RCOOH, carbon getting added. There are questions in which they ask you the conversion of alkyl halide into carboxylic acid. Now if you look at the conversion, R with a X is to be converted into R with a COOH, मतलब I need to add one carbon. So this type of reactions when the number of carbon are increased are called ascending of series. ऐसे reactions जहां पर product के number of carbon बढ़ते हैं, they are referred as ascending of series. And जहां decrease होते हैं, वहां descending बोलते हैं. Descending के कुछ examples already we have done.
Combustion.
ठीक है.
Ascending we have done.
What was the name? Decarboxylation or dry distillation. Any decarboxylation would always have the carbon removed. So the number of carbon in the product is lesser and they will be examples of descending of series. Ascending mein generally three letters hamesha yaad rakho, C, W and G. Ascending of series refers to cyanide, Wurtz and Grignard. कोई भी reaction उठा लो जहां cyanide और Grignard है along with Wurtz will always have the number of carbon more than the reactant. Wurtz में तो सीधा double ही होता है, ये बहुत ही specific reaction है. Cyanide या Grignard का कोई भी reaction देख लो, number of carbons बढ़ेगा. So now this halide can be converted to acid either via cyanide or via Grignard, both. तो RX से how do I get the cyanide?
KCN.
Alcoholic KCN. So substitution would give you cyanide. From cyanide how do I get to acid?
Hydrolysis.
अभी देख लिया hydrolysis. ठीक है? Now from the Grignard, from the halide I can reach to Grignards by
RX
plus Mg in dry ether. And then from Grignard, I can convert this to acid with dry ice, which is solid carbon dioxide. Now this reaction I'll just explain. But Grignard ka reaction hai, to actually bahut simple hai mechanism, main bata dunga phir bhi. But ye conversions bahut important ho gaye, that from the halide, I can convert to acid by two path. One via cyanide and one via Grignards. ठीक है? Now, halides जब भी हम use करते हैं, तो when I do the alcoholic KCN reaction, what type of mechanism is followed?
Substitution
nucleophilic, SN. And when I add the Mg to form RMgX, what type of reaction is this?
Addition
reaction. So, if I talk about SN, there were two paths or mechanisms, SN1 and SN2. And this RX plus alcoholic KCN favors the SN2 mechanism, meaning the halide used should be
primary,
a non-bulky substrate. Primary or a non-bulky substrate. So, as a non-bulky substrate, first I'll convert to cyanide and then uska hydrolysis I'll get acid. But then, if I use a tertiary substrate here, then it will not undergo substitution, it will undergo elimination. And this concept I have discussed multiple times. Eli sub. Jahan substitution nahi hota hai, wahan elimination. And elimination always gives you an alkene. So here this path would not be favorable for a tertiary substrate, because that would give you an alkene and would not get converted into acid. So agar aapko tertiary substrate, yani tertiary alkyl se acid banana hai, तो ऊपर वाला conversion favor नहीं करेगा, नीचे वाला ही use करना पड़ेगा. Because in that case, the RX and Mg are getting just added. There is no substitution which is happening. So, this path would be favorable for any bulky substrate also. समझा? तो अगर आपसे पूछते हैं कि convert tert butyl bromide into tert valeric acid, which did not further give the tert butyl bromide into tert valeric acid, which path would be applicable? Grignard's reagent. And if I use some non-bulky substrate like ethyl bromide and convert this to acid, then it will be alcoholic KCN mechanism. Okay? If I have aromatic substrate Then which will be favorable to form benzoic acid? Okay, haloalkanes are more reactive than halloarenes towards SN reactions. In fact, halloarenes are very less reactive due to three reasons. First is by resonance stabilization of the Br on the benzene. Second, partial double bond character. And third was the hybridization of this carbon, which was sp2. And because of sp2, the bond length between the carbon and bromine would be decreased, and because of that the bond energy would be increased. So ye bond break karna difficult ho jayega. The other preparations of carboxylic acid have a very simple concept. The concept is acid ka derivatives. If you hydrolyze, it will always give you acid. Acid ka derivatives. Now listen to this. If I talk about the carboxylic acid or any acid derivative, they have this part always common, and this part is called acyl. RC double bond O is acyl. Now to this acyl group, I am just attaching different groups. If I attach OH, it is acid. If I attach NH2,
amide.
If I use Cl,
acyl
chloride. If I use OC double bond OR,
anhydride.
It is acid anhydride. CO with OCO is acid anhydride. Then OR dash ester. ONA, sodium salt of the acid, not alkoxide. Do not confuse this with alkoxide. CO oda, now this is Rona alkoxide. CO hai, it is sodium salt of acid, which is carboxylate. ठीक है, मतलब ये सारे के सारे जो है acid के derivatives हैं. ठीक है, if you see amide, chloride, anhydride, ester and salt of the acid, they are all derivatives of acid. और इन सब का नाम prefix के ऊपर ही था, there was just a suffix which was changing. So for the amide, the name would be alkanamide IUPAC, but prefix plus amide, not chloride, it's YL chloride, prefix plus YL chloride, anhydride, prefix plus IC anhydride, IC anhydride, esters, O8 is IUPAC, just 8, I'm talking about common name. No, it's not alkyl ester, wo ether pe aa gaye. Aur ether ester kitni baar bol diya abhi to. Ester is R dash ka naam, then prefix plus 8. O8 IUPAC mein aata hai. O word IUPAC mein hi aata hai. Chahe wo oic acid ka O ho ya O8 ka O ho. It is IUPAC. And ONA is prefix plus 8. This is a salt. ठीक है, एक बार फिर से prefix plus amide, YL chloride, एक anhydride, 8. यहाँ पे R dash का नाम पहले आएगा, यहाँ sodium है पहले आएगा, है दोनों same. बराबर, तो मान लो एक example हम R की जगह CH3 ले लेते, सबका नाम बता दो, quick, first. डूब मरो. अरे idiots. Common name acetic acid. IUPAC not interested. I pointed here. But then too it is not methyl. It is not methyl. Acid ka derivatives, please remember, do not have the nomenclature with respect to alkyl. Itni baat to yaad rakhlo. Aur itne hi acid derivatives hai pure syllabus mein. Iske alawa aur koi acid derivatives hai hi nahi. This and aldehyde, they have the names with respect to prefix only. Ye prefix wala jo bar bar haath dikhata ho na, wo inke liye hai. Along with aldehyde. Please remember that much at least. So nomenclature mein problem nahi hoga. Varna methyl methyl lekar hi chalte rahoge. So the first one will be acetic acid, acetamide, acetyl chloride, acetic anhydride, acetate. It would be alkyl acetate and sodium acetate. R dash, isliye hamesha bolta hu R dash ka naam पहले फिर प्रीफिक्स ऑफ आर एंड देन एट द वर्ड ए. अगर आर इक्वल टू सी एच थ्री के लिए समझ गया तो बाकी सबके लिए सेम वे में अप्लाई करना है. ठीक है, एक और ले लेते हैं. आर इक्वल टू सी सिक्स एच फाइव द फर्स्ट वन बेंजोइक एसिड बेंज अमाइड ओ ड्रॉप करना है उस केस में. बेंजोइल क्लोराइड ओ आ गया इसके अंदर. बेंजोइल क्लोराइड बेंजोइक अनहाइड्राइड benzoate and benzoate. Are you clear with this? इतना याद रख लो, बेटर रहेगा कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड्स के लिए. फिर इसके बाद मैंने कॉन्सेप्ट क्या बताया कि एनी ऑफ दीज एसिड का डेरिवेटिव ऑन हाइड्रोलिसिस विल गिव यू ऑलवेज कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड विथ ऑब्वियसली द सेम आर. ओनली द बाई प्रोडक्ट्स आर गोइंग टू चेंज. So now with the NH2, यहाँ पे RCO will take up with this OH and NH2 and H will give NH3. Next में यहाँ सामने सामने NH3, फिर HCl, फिर RCOH. Meaning acid anhydride का hydrolysis gives you 2 moles of carboxylic acid and generally the R's are same. ठीक है, next alcohol. And this reaction also we have studied. Ester ka hydrolysis gives you acid and alcohol. And the reverse reaction, acid and alcohol gives ester and water. The reaction was named as esterification. And last, NaOH. Clear hai? A compound with C4H8 that is given to be A reacts with HBr to give C4H9Br. Now if it is reacted with HBr, it has to be an alkene and not a cycloalkane. So we have ruled out the possibility of this to be a cycloalkane. Matlab I will clearly write that this is a butene and this is butyl bromide. Ab ye kaun sa butene hai I don't know. ठीक है, तो जितना पता है उतना ही इंफॉर्मेशन आपको एक्सट्रैक्ट करना है. एज ओनली वन प्रोडक्ट, नाउ दिस इज समथिंग इंपॉर्टेंट, एज ओनली वन प्रोडक्ट. अब अगर मैं ब्यूटीन कंसिडर करूं तो हाउ मेनी आइसोमर्स ऑफ फोर कार्बन अल्किन वी हैव एंड दे आर
एन आइसोटर्ट.
अल्किन्स डोंट हैव एन आइसोटर्ट.
Then there'll be two products.
Only two products or single product?
Sorry, single product.
So that's the answer. That itself is the answer. Because they have given you as only product. Ek hi product. Matlab, basically, un teen alkene mein se aapko unsymmetrical alkene rule out karna hai. बताता हूँ. ब्यूटीन में यू कैन हैव ब्यूट वन इन, you can have but 2 in, and you can also have the famous alkene. And when I say famous alkene, it should strike you, isobutyl. So now when they say ki this compound when added with HBr gives you one single product, matlab in teeno mein Markovnikov's rule jisme apply nahi hoga wohi aapka alkene hai. Now if you see this alkene is unsymmetrical, I will have two possible products. So, ruled out. If you see this, it's a symmetrical alkene. Kaise bhi add karo, ek hi product milne wala hai. Yehi answer ho jayega. And agar ye unsymmetrical hai, to ye bhi ruled out. Matlab, butene mein kaun sa butene hai, woh mein confirm ho gaya. It is butene. Samjha? Aage. B reacts with Mg in presence of dry ether to give C. अब अगर ये ब्यूट टू इन है तो कैन आई आइडेंटिफाई द ब्यूटाइल ब्रोमाइड. एच यहां लगाओ, बी आर यहां लगाओ, इट इज गोइंग टू बी अ सिंगल प्रोडक्ट, राइट? एंड दिस वुड बी विच वन?
टू
सेकेंडरी ब्यूटाइल ब्रोमाइड. ये कंफर्म हो गया. आगे उन्होंने बोला ये कंपाउंड बी एम जी के साथ रिएक्ट कर रहा है, तो व्हाट विल हैपन टू दिस? एम जी बी आर बन जाएगा एंड दिस इज योर प्रोडक्ट सी, दैट्स ग्रिग्नार्ड. ठीक है, द कंपाउंड सी दिस रिएक्ट्स विद ड्राई आइस, रिएक्ट्स विद ड्राई आइस दैट इज सॉलिड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड विल गिव यू व्हाट? कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. एंड इफ योर ग्रिग्नार्ड इज आर एम जी एक्स, the acid will be RCOH. The R is not going to change, matlab it will be secondary butyl ke saath COH. And longest chain will be like this, huh? Don't make a mistake of identifying the longest chain as a straight one. It will be 2-methylbutanoic acid. Okay? And this is your compound D. Okay. B reacts with KCN. B is this. So if this reacts with KCN, you will get seg butyl ka
cyanide.
So simply Br ki jaga cyanide. And the product on acidification again gives D. Root 1, root 2, वही concept आ गया. मतलब आप cyanide से acid बनाओ या Grignard से acid बनाओ, acid तो same ही है ना. So इसको hydrolyze कर लिया, ये बन गया. ठीक है? So write chemical equations for all the reactions.